Don't let it worry you, said the cameraman. Even DeMille had a hard time looking through the wrong end. So that was the first...
Don't let me kill the point. Or isn't it a story for grown-ups?
You've heard it. About the time I looked through the wrong end of the camera finder.
Remind me to tell you about the time I looked into the heart of an artichoke.
I'd like to hear it.
Some snowy night in front of the fire. In the meantime, while we're on the subject, would you check on the hors d'oeuvres, Eve? The caterer forgot them. The varnish wasn't dry or something.
Of course.
Looks like I'm in a very fancy party.
I thought you were going to be late.
When I'm the guest of honor?
I had no idea you were even here.
I ran into Eve on the way upstairs, and she told me you were dressing.
That's never stopped you before.
We started talking. She wanted to know about Hollywood. She seemed so interested.
She's a girl of so many interests.
Pretty rare quality these days.
A girl of so many rare qualities.
So she seems.
So you've pointed out so often. So many qualities, so often. Her loyalty, efficiency, devotion, warmth, and affection. And so young. So young and so fair.
I can't believe you're making this up. Sounds like something out of an old Clyde Fitch play.
Clyde Fitch, though you may not think so, was well before my time.
I've always denied the legend that you were our American cousin the night Lincoln was shot.
I don't think that's funny.
Of course it's funny. This is all too laughable to be anything else. You know how I feel about this age obsession of yours. And now this ridiculous attempt to whip yourself up into a jealous froth? Just because I spent 10 minutes with a stage-struck kid.
20.
30 minutes. 40 minutes. What of it?
Stage-struck kid? She's a young lady of qualities. And I'll have you know I'm fed up with both the young lady and her qualities. Studying me as if I were a play or a blueprint, how I walk and talk and think and act and sleep.
Now, how can you take offense to a kid trying to be in every way as much like her ideal as possible?
Stop calling her a kid! As it happens, there are particular aspects of my life to which I would like to maintain sole and exclusive rights and privileges.
For instance, what?
For instance, you.
This is my cue to take you in my arms and reassure you. But I'm not going to. I'm too mad.
Guilty.
Mad. Darling, there are certain characteristics for which you were famous for, on stage and off. I love you for some of them, and in spite of others. I haven't let those become too important to me. They're part of your equipment for getting along in what is laughingly called our environment. You have to keep your teeth sharp, all right. But I will not have you sharpen them on me or on Eve.
What about her teeth? What about her fangs?
She hasn't cut them yet, and you know it. So when you start judging an idealistic, dreamy-eyed kid by the barroom Benzedrine standard of this megalomaniac society, I won't have it. Eve Harrington has never by word, look, thought, or suggestion indicated anything to me but her admiration for you and her happiness at her being in love. And to indicate anything else doesn't spell jealousy. It spells a paranoid insecurity that you should be ashamed of.
Cut, print it. What happens to me in the next reel? Am I dragged off screen to the snake pits?
Miss Channing. The hors d'oeuvres are here. Is there anything else I can do?
Thank you, Eve. I'll have a martini, very dry.
I'll get it. What do you have?
A milkshake.
Martini, very dry.
Muñequita linda, de cabellos de oro, de dientes de perlas, labios de rubí. Dime si me quieres, como yo te adoro, si de mí te acuerdas.
Oh. Uh-oh.